Ariel, one of the things I've heard about you I didn't know early on was that you really haven't been playing basketball for that many years. Is that true, and can you tell me a little bit about that?
Well, I started playing in the third grade, but I didn't start playing like seriously, like taking it very seriously until probably about the sixth, seventh grade. My mom always played. She actually played when I was younger because she was in the military, so she played for like the Marine team, I guess. And I was watching her, but I didn't really pick it up seriously until the sixth grade.
Is that when you start playing competitive? Is that what you call serious?
Yeah, competitive.
What kind of teams were those?
Well, I lived in California, so it was a little different than kind of when I moved here. It was I played against a lot of good competition, and then when I moved here, I kind of worked on my skills and got a little more fundamentally sound and stuff, and played against some more good competition here too.
I'm hearing a lot about the military. A military family?
Yes. My mom and my stepdad were both in the military. My mom retired, I think, 2 years ago, and then my stepdad retired probably about 4 or 5 years ago.
When you come from that kind of background, was it a hard transition to go to college? I mean, a lot of kids come from their families, and all of a sudden they're all by themselves. Is that the way it was for you, or are we kind of used to that kind of movement?
Well, I was pretty used to it because I've gone to a lot of different schools. I mean, I think in elementary school, I went to a new school every year, and then in middle school, too. And in high school, I stayed in the same school for all 4 years. So I was pretty used to it. And then Jewel's not that far away from home, so I'm still pretty close to my family.
A lot of people would say, oh my gosh, that sounds terrible. But is there some benefit from that? What kind of skills have you picked up being in that situation?
Well, like you said, it helped me when I came to college because I'm used to moving and meeting new people. And I think that's probably where it helped me the most is I feel like I'm pretty good with meeting new people and adjusting to new environments.
Let's talk about basketball a little bit. What's your strength on the basketball floor?
Well, I think probably my speed is a little bit of a strength. I feel like I can attack the basket pretty well. And maybe my defense.
Well, you've kind of quietly snuck into the leaders in shooting percentage, steals, that sort of stuff. And yet, that doesn't—you're not real egocentric. It doesn't seem like. Do you enjoy sharing the ball? I would think as a point guard, that's a big thing.
I do. I love assists. I love to give good passes. I think sometimes I pass a little more than I should, but I think I get sometimes more joy from giving the ball up than scoring myself.
Put us in your shoes here for a second. You're coming down the floor on the break. You've got the ball in the middle. What are you thinking about?
I'm probably looking around trying to see who's open, see who's up the floor, so looking for a pass probably.
When you came to Jewel, did you have any idea, or what kind of an idea maybe is a better way to ask you, of the kind of system and everything played here?
I did. I talked to Coach Kress a lot about that before I came. I came up to a lot of practices. I scrimmaged with the team a little bit before, so I had a pretty good idea.
Ariel Smith is our guest here on the HyVee Halftime Report. And Ariel, did you pick up the system quickly? Because as a starter, I would guess you did.
Like I said, I came up a lot last year and scrimmaged when they were in after their regular season. I came up and scrimmaged with them. And in the summer, I played in the league with them. I would come up and scrimmage, and I went to a tournament. So I think I had a lot of time to kind of get used to it and get to gel with the system.
Jill always stresses the importance of being a family as a basketball team. Can you take us inside that a little bit, and how's that been for you?
Actually, it's been really well. I think, like you said, she stresses the importance of being a family, and I think the team really stresses that importance. I feel like we've had a lot of new people on the team this year, I think 9 or something like that. And I think the people that were on the team before us, they did a really good job in welcoming us, and I feel like we're a family.
All right, let's talk about school a little bit. How do you like Jewel as a school?
I love it. It's a little challenging, but that's to be expected. I mean, it's a really high academic school, but I love it thus far.
Yeah, what are you majoring in?
Right now, business. I think I'm going to double major in business and psychology.
You're going to make a lot of money then, is that what you're saying?
Let's hope so. That's the idea.
What do you like to do besides play basketball?
Well, hang out with friends. I like to watch TV when I get a chance, probably sleep. That's pretty much it.
What makes you laugh?
Probably my friends. I love a good comedy movie. That makes me laugh. That's pretty much it.
this season is going to end without a postseason tournament, except for the one we're going to in Vegas. Is that something that bothers you, or do you the women on the team talk about that much?
We haven't talked about it too much. I think it is a little bothering because I would like to see where we could get, but, I mean, we can kind of set a benchmark this year and see where we can get next year.
How would you like that last game to end?
With a win.
Ariel, thank you. And we'll be back with more in a moment on the HyVee Halftime Report.